Students will discuss about prism, then we'll derive prism formula. First of all, prism is a concept. And what is the concept? That generally, as we see, a substance made up of glass and a shape like a wedge shape like structure, which is something like this, I'll show you. This type of shape is called a prism. So you can see that this is one triangular face. There is another triangular face over here. On my side, on your side, there is one triangular face here. This is one rectangular face. This is another rectangular face. And the base on which it is standing is also a rectangular face, like this. So three rectangular faces and two triangular faces. This constitute a prism. Now, if I draw the diagram, then I'll draw like this for you. This is okay, and like this. Okay, so this is how it looks like, and any cross section is the principal section. This is the principal section, I'll say. So if you see from one side, like this is a triangular shape, there is another triangular shape, and there is two inclined faces, and there is a base which is also like this. So when light enters from any inclined face and comes out of the other side that is also inclined face, then that we call as prism. So prism is not of this. We can have any other inclined plane, and one face is this, other face is like this. If light enters from this side and it comes out of that side, then also we call this as a prism. So basically light has to travel through two inclined surfaces. If light passes through two inclined surfaces, then we call that surfaces as prism. Now, if so in a prism we have got two triangular faces, three rectangular faces, and wherever this two inclined planes, these two inclined planes, so where they meet, the line is formed, that is called edge of refracting edge. That is called, so here if I name it A, B, C, D, E, F, this is X, Y, and Z. Then this AD, as you see here, is the refracting this side sections is called a principal section. Any plane which is perpendicular to the refracting edge, it's called principal section. Now, so here ABC or DEF or XYZ, these are called principal section. Okay, these two sides A, D, E, B and A, C, F, D, the inclined planes, they are called refracting surfaces. Okay, they are called refracting surfaces, and this angle is called angle of prism. This is the angle of the prism, or this is the angle of the prism, or this is the angle of the prism. If light has to pass from this side and comes out of that side, then this angle that form is called prism angle or angle of prism. So if light comes from this side and then finally emerges out of this, then these two inclined planes, as you can see here, this is one inclined plane, this is another inclined plane, they meet here, So this angle that is formed is called the prism angle. A is called prism angle, but that is not constant for a prism, because if I change the side, then the prism angle will be different. What do you mean by that? Now what I want to say is, if I have a section, principal section for prism, let us consider the ABC is a principal section. Now in this case, what happens is light enters from this inclined plane, gets refracted, and then finally emerges out. So there is one refraction occurring here, then next refraction is happening here. So refraction is occurring two times, but then finally it comes out like that. Then in this case, A is called the angle of prism. Here A is the angle of prism. But when it enters from here, okay, it enters from here and then comes out like that. Then if light enters like that and comes out from this side, then here A is not considered as the prism angle, rather B is considered as the prism angle. So prism angle is the angle between two inclined planes. So similarly, I can say if a ray goes like that, comes like that, comes out like that, then C is the prism angle here. Here C is the prism angle. So how the light moves in which two inclined surfaces it moves. If it moves in AB and AC, these two planes, as you can see here, this AC, DF, AB, ED, this way, then this side to that side, then it is like this, from this surface to that surface. Obviously it don't move straight, but I'm just showing that if the light moves from this side to that side, then these are the refracting surfaces, and this is the angle of the prism. They are inclined like that. So you can see that this is the angle of the prism. Okay. Now, what happens in other cases, that if the light moves from BC, if you see here, here is AB, and this is your from that side to from this side, it enters is a triangular face. Okay, it's a triangle. So from your side is a triangle. If it enters from here and comes out like that, then this angle is now the angle of the prism. So it depends on which sides the ray takes. So depending that you have got the prism angle. So this is edge, refracting edge, this plane and this plane are the refracting planes. When they meet, it forms a line. The line is called edge. And the angle between the two that is here, the angle A is obviously equal to angle D. So this is a prism angle, so the light travels like that. Or otherwise, which two sides it passes, it considers the prism angle. This is the base of the prism. Okay. And basically, you can have a slab, glass slab, like this. Suppose that I have a glass slab which is something like this. Okay, so glass slab. Now this glass slab is also considered as a prism, because if it enters like that and comes out like that, then these are the two inclined planes. So it is also a prism. So prism is a concept between two inclined planes, ray passing through them. Okay, thank you.